Hi, a very good morning. This is Abhay from Manupatra Informations. Thank you for joining me for an orientation session on Manupatra. I hope you are at home, safe with your family at this difficult time for all of us. Credit goes to you guys who are making the most of it by brushing up on your legal research skills. This is the part one of the three sessions we are organizing exclusively for students. This will be of 30-40 minutes. Any questions that you might have, you can note it down. We'll answer it at the end of the session. Let me begin with a brief introduction to my company. Manupatra Information Solutions started its journey in the year 2000 as the pioneers of the online legal search in India. Today, we are the largest content aggregator for Indian and international database. We have our offices across 22 cities across India. What has helped us stay relevant in 20 years is our singular focus on technology. So we see ourselves as a technology company and not just as a database provider. So a lot of thought goes into how to use new technologies like artificial intelligence, visualization tools, editorial tools to make our user aware of the most relevant data that is in the sea of data that is available outside. Okay, with that, let me begin with the session. So we are assuming that you have somewhat legal knowledge, but no information about Manupatra. So we'll start everything from scratch. Say, let's start. You just have to type manupatra.com on the URL. So it will load to Manupatra or manupatrafast.com. Both are the exact same thing. So once you go to manupatra.com, there will be a username or a password that will be assigned to you. If your college or a firm has an IP subscription, an option will be available here for the IP user access. So you can click on that one and you will be easily able to enter into the site. So to sign into the portal, there is this arrow that is being given. Just click onto this one. Now this will be my home screen. So this is how Manupatra looks from the inside. On the left-hand side, we have our table of contents. So this is everything that we are covering. On the right-hand side, these are the different searches. Manu search is the legal search, citation search. So any search engine you go to, the first thing is where the search bar. Here is the search bar for Manu search. Similarly, legal search is there for appellant, respondent, for different things. So we can come to that at the later half of the session. Let's start with table of contents. So table of content in Manupatra has two major functions. One is it will show you where a particular document is located in Manupatra server. Okay, that's number one. Number two is if you're searching for a particular, say if you're looking for just a notification circular, you are very sure that you know this is a notification circular I want. So you can just select from it and then make your search. So it will only search in the notification circular folder. Similarly, if you're looking for a Supreme Court judgment, just select from here and then make your search. So that way you can just refine your search before even making your search. It can act as a filter. Let's show you some of the coverage that we have. So for opening any folder, there is this button that is plus sign that is available just beside it. Click onto that button and this will open. So, okay, this is Supreme Court judgments and Supreme Court orders, both we cover. Supreme Court judgments from 1950, since inception till today, all the Supreme Court judgments are available on the website. Okay. Similarly, Supreme Court orders from 1980 till today, all the Supreme Court orders are also there on the website. Let me go to High Courts. So all the 24 High Courts judgments from inception is available. Say, let me show you for once. Say Calcutta High Court, oldest court in India. See, from 1860 till today, all the judgments from Calcutta High Courts are available in the website. Similarly, other courts are also there. So this is nobody is covering, like in terms of Privy Councils, the old decisions, 1850 onward also we cover. So very comprehensive coverage for Supreme Court and High Courts. Let's go to the tribunals and commissions. So tribunals and commissions, all the 40 of them, the major tribunals we cover. So CAT, NCLT, DRT, ITAT, all these are available. Say NCLT is very popular among advocates these days. So benches-wise decision also you can say Delhi bench, Kolkata bench. So if you're looking for a Delhi bench decision, you can just click onto this one and you will only go to the It'll only search in the New Delhi venue decision. Okay, let's go to the international database. So international database, we cover Supreme Court decisions from Commonwealth English speaking countries plus US and UK. International Court of Justice is also there. So say for United States, Supreme Court decisions are available from 1760 onwards. Okay, so very comprehensive coverage for the international database as well. So when you are using Manupatra, you are able to use search both in the national and international database. Say I'm searching for something like right to privacy, which is also a national issue as well as a global issue. So both the judgments, international and national judgments, will be able to see from here. Okay, coming to the next one, say business policy. Business policy is again very interesting. So in business policy, what we have done is, on particular subjects of law, you will be able to see all the primary and secondary database in one folder. Okay, now what does that mean? Say corporate laws, just expand onto this folder. Now this is the table of content, this is the hyperlink. Now I can click onto this one. So once you click on the hyperlink, this will be the folder there. So here primary database is the central acts, rules, regulations, state acts. So these are all the primary database that is coming directly from the authority. Now the secondary database is annual reports, committee reports, concept papers. So Manupatra, many people think that we just have judgments, but we cover a lot of things. Say I'm a corporate lawyer, I need to update myself on a particular topic. So here is everything. Due diligence is available, circulars notification is what new is coming on my particular field. Say, let me click on one, say due dates and diligence. So from here you will be able to see offenses, punishment, remarks. So different section wise also we have segregated these. Similarly, this is available, say corporate law. This is also available for real estate. So real estate is again very prominent sector. So real estate, press releases, reports, FAQs. So these are FAQs that are prepared by our editorial team. So if you have some question about this, so some of these are available from here also. So you can just click this one and find out, you know, if you have a query. Okay, so this is there, all the primary and secondary database for a particular subject in one folder in business policy. Arbitration also we cover in this. Let's go to the next one. This is corporate law and taxation. GST, again, evolving subject of law. So on this particular, new press releases keep on coming. So as a taxpayer, I need to be updated on this. So everything is available to me in one folder. Just I need to go to this folder whenever I open Manupatra, and I can keep myself updated. Okay, now next one is notification circular. So different ministries keep coming up with their different notification circulars. Say central we cover, state we are the only one that are covering the state notifications as per today. So like central, from 2020 onwards, from 2008 to 2019, say I want to see from 2020 onwards. So these are all the ministries, and you can select anyone. Say I want to go to Ministry of Health and Family Affairs. So I just click onto this folder until I see the hyperlink. So now I can see the hyperlink. Just click onto this one. This will give me a table, say 2020. And now it lists all the notification that has been coming from this particular ministry. Now I want to see a particular one, say amendment. Okay, so this is how a notification is looks like in Manupatra. Again, I'd like to bring your notice to a small feature, but very, very useful. So this is hyperlinking. So hyperlinking, comprehensively hyperlinked Manupatra databases. So any circular is hyperlinked with a particular section. So any section is being mentioned in this one, where you can just click on 10A and you will be able to read 10A. If you want to read judgments on this 10A, also you can do from there. Again, any previous notification circular that was mentioned in this one, that is also hyperlinked. Then you can just click and you will be able to get to the. So if you are opening a government website for this particular notification and there are like 10 different notification circulars that were mentioned, to go to 10 different places. Okay, here everything is available to you in one go. So you just have to click on the button and be able to get there. So this is gadget copy. So as it is appearing on their website, so if you want that. So this is also, print replica is always available, even for any judgment also. This is as it is from the source. So we are giving you the source as well. You can take out a print out of this feel like you can always take out of PDF format from here. So if you want to save this in your hard drive, that you can do. If you can say, if you want to send an email for this, that you can do. You can save it in Manupatra folder. That is also possible. So this is for notification circulars. Now, Bayer Acts, very, very important folder for any legal practitioner. I'll just open this. So just click on the plus sign. Central and state, both are present. Now in central, we have Bayer Acts and rules and regulations. Rules and regulations also we cover. Bayer Acts is also there. Now, once there is a hyperlink, click onto this one. This is again arrange them, these Bayer Acts, in chronological, say 2020, alphabetical wise, subject wise, industry wise. Say industry wise, I just want to see FMCG Bayer Acts, so that I can do. Alphabetical is also there. So A, B, C, D. Once you click on to all, you'll be able to see all the Bayer Acts from A to Z. All the Bayer Acts are available to you in one folder. All the amendments are also there. So, say this is Aadhaar Targeted Act 2019. Now, the amendment came in 2019. So, the amendment is also present, and this particular act will be amended as per today. So, this will be there. So, let's go to one. Say, I've chosen Consumer Protection Act because of this flag. So, 2019, this has been passed. Everything is done. Just the date of enforcement is not there. So this is a very, very important information for me. So if I'm going to the court or if I'm going for a particular moot, so this is, these small icons are available everywhere in Manupatra just to notify you. You know, this is something that needs your attention. So just whenever you put your finger on this one, the pointer, you'll be able to get. Okay, let me show you all the functionalities related to any Bayer Act. So this is 1986 one. Let's open this one. So if you, I want to open this, all the folders are available here. Let's start with this one. This is view in single document. So this is 1986. If you want to take out a printout of this, that you can do. If you want to simply copy paste direction, that you can do. Everything that has come through a, you know, substituted from a Bayer Act, in amendment has come, that is also there. So you can click on to this and it will take you to the Bayer Act. Now let me go back. Commentaries are available. So it's primary, this data, and secondary is always available. If you want to read commentary on the particular subject, that is always available to you. Okay, this is there. Go to the next feature. Annotations. So brief notes on the same act is also present. This is comparative charges, very, very helpful. See, what is the difference between 1986 and 2019? Which section is what? Say, sometimes we just remember this section name. So that if you want to check or verify to yourself, so that you can always do from here. Rules and regulations. So rules and regulations are also available. So here, from here, what you will see is everything related to a particular Bayer Act is available to me in a one list. And for that Bayer Act, all the information I need is also here. So this is if any bill is pending on that this act, or what is the statement of objective of that act, that is also present. It is also present in vernacular, Hindi, English, different forms. If you want to download or see for yourself, that also you can do. Okay, these are some features. Now this is another feature. So this is also hyperlinks. So if I click onto this one, what happens? Section wise it opens section 1, section 2, section 3. I just want to read section 8. I just click onto this one, it will ask me whether I want to read the act or the commentary. I want to read the act. So now section act is opened from here. And if you want to read the act, next one, if you want to send this as a mail. So mail option is always available, print option is always available. I want to read different sections. See, section 5 is also available. Now I want to read judgments, landmark judgments on section 5 by Supreme Court. That also you can see. So everything is available to you at a click of a button. So we have ensured that same screen will get everything. Okay. Another one is if I want to search judgments on it, says section 8 only, I want to see judgments. So this is there, the open judgment, this blue button is there. Let me click on to this one. Okay, so this will give me like 37 results on Consumer Protection Act Section 8. How to open this judgment, that we'll discuss in the second half. Okay, so this is a very, very important folder. I'll show you, like, this is the Bare Act folder, Central State Table of Content, and you will be able to get it. Let me show you one more thing. Companies Act 2013. Any bill is also pending, that information also we give. So 2013, there is a bill pending on this on 2020. Let me click on to this one. From here you will be able to see which is the amendment that is pending on this one. Now, on which sections this amendment is pending? What is this bill? So this is all available to you. Small details are taking into consideration here. Okay, so this is for Bare Acts, central as well as state Bare Acts are also there. So if you want to see for any rules and regulations are also available for these particular states, bills, drafts, committee reports. So committee reports are also present, so law commission reports or constituent assembly debates, again very important. We have done segregation. Say if you want to see on human rights, what are the new reports that different government, non-government bodies keep coming up with their recommendations, that all you can see from here. Similarly, court fees, court forms, court rules, all these are available. Now drafts. So drafts, you might be interning somewhere, you need, you know, draft for this. So both the PDF and Word format is available. You can click anyone from here. If you want to take out a Word format, that is available, PDF. So thousands of drafts are available at your disposal, categorized subject wise. You can just click any one of these. Very helpful. Pending bills. So if there's any bill that is pending on the parliament and you want to check the assent date or how it was passed, what was the objective behind this bill. So we get these kind of calls from clients, like 2005, this bill was passed. What is the objective and purpose? So this is all available to you from here. So title of the bill, bill number, status, assent date, very, very important. Enforcement date, very important. So these are all small things that one can get from here. Again, Lok Sabha, as it was passed by Lok Sabha, as it was passed by both houses. So the entire source document is available. So we're living in a WhatsApp university age. Makes so much sense to just go back to the source data and check from here. Okay, so stamp duty is there, stamp valuation is there, forms, statutory forms are there based on different subjects, miscellaneous is there. So miscellaneous, what we have done in miscellaneous is like the budget session is there, this is updated same day it comes, that is there, extradition treaties with different countries, nation cases in use. So these are the district high court cases, district court cases, which are more coming in news, that also you can see from here. One might be here somewhere. This is okay. So all these cases are also uploaded in Manupatra, can be found here. Ebooks, say Code of Criminal Procedure, different ebooks are also present. If you just want to read, you can always do that. Chapter wise, you can download them also. So if I want to read it offline, from here I can download or print. Different subject ebooks are also available. Again, academic ebooks are also there. Academic ebooks is just a small difference between a regular ebook and academic ebooks. Here we have hyperlinked also. So if you're reading a book and you want a judgment, there's some judgment that is mentioned in this one. You can always click here, read the judgment, come back to the book. So again, only possible in digital medium. Let's come to the articles. So articles also are also present, students, professionals, different devices send us articles. If you want to send us articles, you can reach out to us at the rate Manupatra. I'll share it at the end of the presentation. From here you can select the subject or you can just write here. Right. let's search. So that also we can do. I think there's some mistake in this spelling. Okay, so articles, basically you can see from here. Let's go to the next one, say legal taxonomy. This is just like a digest. So what we have tried to do here is mimic your book. Okay, so there in books there are subjects, sub subjects. So civil procedure is one sub subject that is there on the on your book. So sub subject you can select. At the end of it you will get judgments on the sub subjects. So you don't have to even go to Manu search or legal search for these. Everything we have created this hierarchy for you. You can say just select the subject and go on selecting your sub subject. This also you can use in your MOOCs. Find the relevant judgments on a particular subject, sub subject. Okay, so we have another 30 minutes remaining with us. So what we'll go do is we'll go on to the more exciting part of the demo. So this is the search engine of Manupatra. So basically this is our bread and butter. So this is what we are known for. Manu search is there, legal search is there, citation search is there, assisted search is there. So Manu search is basically the heart of Manupatra. This is, we go to our clients, they've been using it for 20 years. This is their absolute favorite search because it uses on the back end a lot of technologies like artificial intelligence, natural language processing. But for you as a user, what that means is it's very simple to search in Manupatra or in Manu search in particular. So from here you will be able to make your query. Say I don't have to frame a query, I don't have to use plus minus, that's not necessary. You can do that, but it's not necessary. Today what I'll do is I'll quickly show you all the most used features. Tomorrow we can always elaborate on each and specific feature. Okay, let's start with a query. Say compassionate appointment for a host daughter. Make my search. Okay, so no, nothing in. In like half a second, it has searched through millions of judgments and found 510, which are most relevant to me. These are the 510 judgments on compassionate appointment for divorced daughter. Okay, now this is the judgment. First thing that people do is they just click on the title and it opens. Okay, there's some problem with the net. Okay, let us open it in a new window. So from here you will be able to access this particular case in a new window. So if I want to open Malti Kumari versus State of Bihar in a new window, just click here. Some problem with the net. Okay, so now this judgment has opened. There was some problem with the net. Okay, so from here, I've opened that judgment from the title. So when I need to go back, this back button doesn't work. You can always click onto this results button to go back to your previous search. So this is one of the very frequently asked questions. How do we go back once we have opened this from the title? So that you can do by the results button here. Okay. Now I can always open this in a new window. So that is much more feasible. You know, just click onto this one, it will open in a new window. So any judgment that you see that is helpful, you can just click on this one and your results page will be very much there in the background. Okay. So now this is one judgment that's helpful for me. So I don't want to read it first. I just want to see the case note. So this is that button. So just click onto this arrow. So what this is, Manu Instant. Manu Instant gives me a brief editorial synopsis of the judgment. So it gives me the subject, the citing reference, which were the cases which were discussed in this case, which were the cases which were mentioned in this case. That is there. Act, case note, disposition. So all this information is available without opening the judgment. Or I can always read that. Held in every case of death of government servant in harness, it might not be possible. There was no vested interest. So here she has been denied the compassionate appointment. Now this is not helpful. Let's read the next one. So this is again Allahabad High Court, Kushum Devi. So here, but the Honorable Judge Saab has said, divorced daughter dependent upon her father, continued to be the liability of her father, has to be included in the minimum. So here she has been granted compassionate appointment of her father. Okay. Now this I see has been cited in six other judgments also, 2001 judgment. What I can do here is I can just open this judgment. This is how it will look in Manupatra, any judgment, case note will be there. Cases referred will be there. This is the button I just want you to focus on. This is cited in para. So what cited in para does for you is it gives me the list of judgments where this has been cited, six judgments where this has been cited. Now it also goes a step further. It gives me which paragraph of these judgments. Okay. So I need not read the entire judgment. I can always read the paragraph only from here. And if I find this particular paragraph helpful, I can always go to the. This is cited in para that is available from here. Okay, let's go back. Let me make another search from here. Say order 7, rule 11. Okay. I'll make my search. So, a very common search, but very specific, you know, order 7, rule 11A. So many search engines are not able to do this. So then they'll not be able to find judgments on order 7, rule 11. Even if they do, there'll be a very complex procedure to go about this. So here, everything, you just type it out and system will do the rest for you. So order 7, rule 11, here you will see that it will also pick up Roman numbers. So on whichever judgment, order 7, rule 11, it's coming in like numeral format also, it will automatically take this to show you the efficiency. Now let's do one another search in Manu, then we'll go to legal search. Say gender justice, a broad query. So now on gender justice, I'm getting 6780 results. So sometimes people ask, I don't want to read 6780 judgment. So the idea is that you don't have to read these judgments. So because our algorithm is such that you don't have to go to the second page also. So most of the relevant judgments are available to you on the first page. So algorithm we have created in terms of which case is being cited, the different equations that goes into it, gives you the best result. Now I don't want relevance right now, I want the newest one. So you can always see the which is the newest in this topic. Also, I want to see the cited most. So this has been cited 624 times, Vishakha landmark judgment on gender justice. Again, this Kerala High Court judgment has been cited just 4 times. Again, a Kerala High Court judgment 8 times. So if I wanted to see just the most cited case on this particular topic, there's a filter available for that. Okay. Just one more thing. The difference between all these judgments and this judgment is, this judgment has a flag. So whenever you see a red flag, you need to be a little cautioned. just click on to this one. It will show me that this particular case is overruled. Okay, eighth case has a red flag. It has been overruled. I can click on to this one, and it will automatically that comes where it was overruled. That is solved from this. You just click on to the red flag. It will take you to the case which has overruled. SP Gupta. So this is a very common query that we get. How do we find out that a particular case is overruled or not? Whichever case has this flag, that is overruled. Whichever that case doesn't have this flag, that is not overruled. It might have been dissented in some other case, but not overruled. So this is how to find out if your particular judgment is a good law or not. So this was for Manu search. There's a lot to do. See, search and result is also there. So search and result is, these are like 6,780 judgments. Now I want to search more specific, say minor. So I can always refine this search. Okay. Wherever minor word is coming, that I can do. Always from here, search and result, I can more explore. So this is something that you can do, and this is not available everywhere. In Google search, we type like 2-3 sentences at one go. Sometimes people do that in Manu search. You can always refine your search. Start with a broad search, and you can search and result to the relevant judgment. This in detail will be explained in tomorrow's session. How to use Manu search best using Boolean algorithms. If you don't want, we have a different assisted search for you. So there is a lot to unpack here that we'll do tomorrow. Now coming to the next one, this is legal search. Now how different is Manu search and legal search? Legal search gives you the exact parameters. So if you are looking for, say, particular section, judgment on a particular section, from where at also you can go. If you don't want that, you can search from legal search here. If you have a particular party name, appellate respondent, otherwise you can do. If you're looking for in judgment for that particular case note, that you can do. Say for that particular act, I just want to see Negotiable Instruments Act 138. Okay. You can search. Okay. So this is giving me 14,000 some results where NI 138 is involved. So sometimes you start with a section and then you can always go to your query. So search and result will always be there in any search. So you can always refine to your relevant judgment. So search and result will be there. So if you have a particular section in mind, go to legal search, start with that section, and then you can always refine it. Okay, now let's say I want to see this most important case in NI 138. Till the time it's loading, you can also see the filters also are available. So keyword wise filter is there. Okay, cited most. In terms of periods, if you want to see the judgments with 2010 and above judgments, if you want to see that, you can see the recent ones. Business policy, you can also see there are like 13,000 judgments on this. Industry wise, so if you are looking for a particular industry, that you can do. Judge bench wise, if you want to see the judgments where like a higher judge bench was sitting, that you can do from here. Open any one judgment, the Supreme Court. The system. Let's go back to legal search. Okay. Let's go back. I'm sorry, the net is creating some problems. Let's select NI again and go to section 138. I can make my search from here. Title wise, I've selected A to Z. Let's go to cited most wise, so which is the most cited on this subject. So this is Bangladesh High Court judgment, Madhya Pradesh High Court judgment. From here, you can also see the decision party name, the date of the decision, and the court of the decision also. So this has been cited one time, Manupatra. So this is negotiable instruments act 138. So from here you will be able to see that in a particular judgment we have also hyperlink. So any, since 138 is the section that is being coming, so you can just click on to this one. It will take me to whichever act 138 if you want to read the commentary. So similarly, every section is hyperlinked, every case law which is mentioned, this is hyperlinked. If I want to take out a like simple copy paste from here, so that I can do. These, the entire case note is available from here. Int replica is available, so tell the law journal. For any judgment, you'll also have a copy available from here. So let's search in Manu. Let's open a landmark judgment for you. Okay. So on appointment of arbitrator, I have selected the cited most, given a 1994 judgment. Okay, so this is the judgment as it will look on Manupatra. Everything is hyperlinked, like I was telling you. Now, in front of any judgment, you will also find this wheel. So what does this wheel tell me? Tells me where this case has been cited recently. So another, on 8th April, a case has come where this case is cited, has been cited. It has been discussed 50% of times. It has been mentioned 32% times. So you get information just from the name of the case also. You can get a lot of information about the case without even opening it. So you read a judgment, you find this link, information is there. Now, if you want to find out a meaning of a particular word, there's a dictionary option available. So you can just double click on any word. You will be able to find the English as well as Hindi dictionary meaning. So what I'm doing here is circumstances. I'm just double clicking on this one. No more is option appears. From here, you'll be able to see the English and Hindi meaning of that particular word. Okay. Comprehensively hyperlinked, small features that are very helpful for you. Let's go on the top. Again. Want to directly go, just use this one. So this will be how it is looking. 1996 judgment, the case name, subject is there. If you want to see the contract, case, constitution, these are the acts that were mentioned in this case, and there is a separate option available which is a relevant section. So out of these, all the acts, all the sections, it was based on CRPC section 482. So we have segregated this, so our editorial team does it. Cases referred, which were the cases referred in this case, and the entire list is here. You can click any one of them. Citing references there, prior history. So this judgment came from Delhi High Court. That is being linked. So any information that you need to have for this particular judgment, that is available to you from here. Citing references there. So citing reference basically gives me, now out of these many cases that were cited in this case, which were mentioned, which were discussed, these cases. 15 cases which were discussed in this. Now, which were the cases which were dissented in this particular case? So, similarly, if it any case have been affirmed or relied on this case, there would have been a separate tab for that. Okay. Now, this will be the Manu citation. Once you click onto this one, it will give you the equivalent citation. So, equivalent citation, we have 320 plus journals. So, AIR, SEC, DRT, all these journals will be able to get the equivalent citations also. Okay. So, these are some of the very, very important icons that are available in any of the judgment. So, you can just, next time you go to Manu Patra, you can click on each one of these and find out. So, this is view commentary. So, if there is any commentary on this judgment, that you can do. So, this is from PM Bakshi, sir. This is available here. Now, this is important para. So, this is artificial intelligence working for you. So, what important para gives me is the most key paragraph of the judgment. So, this is 1994 and we are saying that this particular paragraph is very important. Now, how do we come to that conclusion? Because this has been cited 7 times in future judgments. Okay. So, in other words, what this feature is giving me are the list of paragraphs which are most quoted in a particular judgment. So, in this particular judgment, Tata Cellular versus Union of India, these are the different judgments which have been quoted in future judgments. Now, this particular paragraph has been quoted 7 times. Coming to the next one, say this particular paragraph has been quoted 5 times. Okay. So, it's giving me the list of the key paragraphs of the judgment, and now I've find that 85 paragraph is actually what I was looking for. So, I get a list of 5 more judgments which I can read from here only. So, I don't need to go outside and search. So it's giving me, it's being quoted here. From here, I can just open this one. So, this is very, very helpful. So, I need not read the entire judgment. I can just quickly go to important para and see which are the paragraphs which are relevant. If I see one point that is relevant to me from there, I can of course read other judgments also. So this is important para. Now the next one is cited in para. So cited in para gives me the judgment of a future judgment. So this judgment came in 1996. Now what cited in para will give me is the judgments where this has been cited. Okay. So, this has been cited recently in a Supreme Court. So, oftentimes there is this question, you know, is this particular case followed somewhere else? So, that gives you, I've shown you earlier also, this gives you the list where it has been followed, and it also gives me the paragraph where it has been followed. So, this is the 12th paragraph where this 1996 judgment has been followed recently. The entire list is there. You can always copy paste from here. You don't need to even open the judgment. If you find this is relevant, you can always click onto this button and it will take you to the next judgment. Comprehensively hyperlinked. Now, this is authority timeline check. I'll come to this after case map. So, what case map is again very much appreciated. So, case map basically gives you a list of 20 most relevant judgments related to Tata Cellular. So, you can always take Tata Cellular 1994 as a timeline. So, these are the judgments that have come prior 1994. So, these were mentioned, relied, discussed. So, these were referred in this judgment. And from here, color, you can see this particular judgment was dissented in. Ajit Thakur was dissented in Tata Cellular. Similarly, this case was discussed in Tata Cellular. So, these are all the prior cases and their citing reference in Tata Cellular. Now, what happens on the right-hand side? This becomes interesting. Now, what happens after 1994? Another judgments come, 1998, Ronak International Limited, where Tata Cellular were discussed. Again, Air India case, where this was relied on. Jagdish Mandal case came and it dissented with, not overruled, dissented with Jagdish. So, from here, you will be able to see all the treatments. Now, once I've clicked on Jagdish Mandal, brought my pointer to this, it's showing me 4 other judgments which it has dissented. Okay. So, from here you will be able to get the cross references also. So, in this decision, Tata Cellular was distinguished and it further affirmed and relied on two other cases. Okay, this is all available to you. Oh, let me click on, say, this judgment, Om Kumar versus others. Now, this will be the center. Now, this is Om Kumar becomes the center, and I can follow Om Kumar, where this was relied on, where this was discussed. So, this was not possible like 10, 20 years. People couldn't have think about this one. So, in the libraries, people have to use a lot of books. Here, everything, because of the technology, everything is available to you. You can go 3 degrees forward. So I can always click on this judgment also, 2005 judgment, and I can follow 2005 judgment also. So now 2005, V. Ramanna versus and others versus APSRTC. So this judgment also I can see. So where this was relied on, where this was discussed. Also, there's a small thing that I'd like to point out, that here, from here, you will see that the size of the balloon also matters. So if this particular judgment has a bigger circle, this particular judgment in itself has been cited more number of times. If this has a small size, that means this particular judgment has been cited a lot less. If I want to read the case note, number of times it has been cited, that also you can do. So a lot of information available to you in a bird eye view from one particular icon. So this was case map. Now I had left this for case map. So now case map gives me 20 relevant judgments. So it was giving me 20 judgments. Now what case map does for me is it gives me the list of all the judgments. So it has been referred to 2 judgments. So 2,222 judgments it has been referred. So this gives me the entire list. Okay. Which are the Calcutta judgments, which are the Delhi over the years 1994 till today, how many times? Now, if it's getting two, so you can always reduce this. I don't want to see 2222. I want to see 320 only. So it will only show the 320. Now, again, I just want to see cases that are relevant to me. Say I want to see the relied on cases only, where this was relied. Say I want to see the distinguished cases only. So all this is available. Now, somebody else is bringing this case, the opposing lawyer. I want to see the cases where this was dissented. So that is also available. So the complete citing reference is there and where this judgment was cited. So each and every judgment is available. Again, size is of matter here. So this particular judgment has been cited 558 times. And this is another Supreme Court judgment that has been just cited 29 times. So more the size, the bigger the size of the balloon, the bigger the more the landmark the judgment, the more times it has been cited. Okay. So this was authority timeline. Now, if there are some common words that are occurring in this judgment, that you can always go to from here. PDF format is there. So if you want to see the PDF format for this judgment, that with or without question note, you can take a printout from here. If you want to send an email to a friend or a colleague, subscriber, non-subscriber, no problems. You can just select here and put in the email ID. So just put in the email ID, select send, it will be go in attachments. Word format, if you want for formatting, word format is also available. Sticky note, very important feature, we'll discuss it tomorrow. This is if you want to upload it in the cloud. So if you want to upload it, say in your Dropbox or Google Drive for your own use later. If you want to save it in Manupatra cloud, that is also possible. So there's a folder available here of my saved documents. You can always use this one. Okay. So this was for legal search. We've discussed Manu search. We have discussed legal search. Let's quickly discuss citation search. Citations, we covered 320. Citations from different journals. So from volume 1 till volume to present today. So Taxman is there, SEC, DLT. So all these books also you'll be able to access. I want to go to AIR Supreme Court. So some softwares want you to have a particular format in mind, nothing like that. So you can just select volume number, page number. You can make this from here. Okay, so this was about it. Just one few things that we'll discuss today. Tomorrow we'll discuss each of these searches in detail tomorrow. Let's go to sign off. I'll show you how to keep yourself updated from Manupatra. So there are different options that are available to you. So one is this one on desktop. So you can download this plugin in this particular software in your desktop. So whenever you open your system, you'll have this desktop alert that will be there. So if you want to read this, that you can do. Now, from here, you can also add this extension. The entire procedure has been described here. Just whenever you are working on Chrome, just a brief snapshot of what happened today, you'll be able to get from here. Another one is Newsroom. So Newsroom basically, as the name suggests, it gives you which are the landmark judgments, which are the notification circulars, international judgments, what's happening these days. So COVID-19 is there. Always subscribe to our e-news line. Just put in your email ID here and let go. So these news lines also every week, we like 6th April and 13th April. So this will also come in your email. If you have a Telegram account, you can always download the Telegram Messenger app, and we have a channel there, Manu Patra Channel 7. So just one single message comes every day with synopsis of all the major happenings in the legal fraternity today that you can access from there. Okay, so that is about it for me today. If you have any question, I'll be more than happy to answer. Okay, it was some eco problem. Okay, so we'll be doing the keywords important session tomorrow. Amendments, how can we access updates with all the latest amendments? Okay, so that you can do from the newsroom from here. I'll just try to answer as much as I can. Is there any link available in today's? This will be uploaded on our YouTube channel. Just go to YouTube manupatra.com. All the sessions that we are doing these days, that will be available. Okay, sir, we'll be doing the refine search comprehensively tomorrow. So we'll be using all the Boolean search nesting. In tomorrow's session, we'll be discussing that. Voice, tomorrow we'll use another way. Sir, we cover most of the reported judgments and unreported ones also. So if there is any problem in terms of judgments, you can always write to us. Say we have a email ID, contact@manupatra.com. You might also have a relationship manager that is dealing with your own client, your own college. So from there also you will be able to access. Okay, go to just YouTube. From there, you will be able to just type Manu Patra. Okay, and this is our channel, Manu Patra, with 76 subscribers. You can click on to this one. And here, everything that we have been doing in last couple of days, today's session will also be available here. Yes. Telegram's channels, you can go to the Manu Channel 7 and join it. Just search Manu Channel 7 and you will be able to find that. Sir, we don't segregate in terms of reported and unreported. Both the judgments are available. So we provide the copy for that judgment, but we don't segregate reported and unreported. So the Consolidated Act is available in the Beer Act. So if you go to the Stamp Duty Act, say I go from Legal Search, Act Search, Stamp Duty, and say for Delhi. So this schedule will be updated as per today. Any new notification or anything that has changed in this will be available here. So this will be amended as per today. Sir, we are providing right now only seminars for students. I'll take you over to management. We do have a mobile application for Manupatra. You can go to your Play Store or your iTunes and you can download Manupatra from there. Okay, the Telegram slide is this one. You can go to Manupatra Channel 7. Okay, how many case laws? Sir, from the Bear Act, you can see top 5-10 judgments, but you can make the search in Manu search and you will be able to see as many are there on CPA Section 5. Sir, the IP address link is available only if you are connected to your college IP address. So if you are connected to the Wi-Fi address of your college, that will be available there. If there is a problem, please contact us from your school's college ID to contact@manupatra, and our IT team will be able to help. Okay, sir, I'll take this suggestion for Zoom app. Okay, ma'am, you can get in touch with your college authorities. They can always approach us. We'll try to do what the best we can do. Sir, for periodic updates, you can always set search results from here. So in Manu search, we have an option for save search. So you will be able to access the updates that we'll be covering tomorrow. Yes, Gautam sir, we do have an app. You can download it from Play Store. You will be able to access it from the username password. Sir, Manupatra Channel 7 is... Income Tax Act is available full completely. I just show you. So let's go to Manupatra, go to the Bear Act Central, go to alphabetical, select all. Tax is available from here, agriculture. Okay, let's go back to the questions. That is available from there. So the main act is available, Sumit sir. Boolean search is there. We'll be discussing it tomorrow. That we'll be discussing in this session tomorrow, the Boolean search, how to use AND and OR. This session is available on YouTube, yes. Okay, so we'll be discussing the how to use different searches in Manupatra. So all the acts will be also covered in this. Okay, so, ma'am, this Sonam ma'am, this will be available on our YouTube page. You can always go there and refresh. IP access is when you have a IP subscription in your college. So in that particular IP, we make the particular Manupatra will be away. People can log in. Any number of people can log in from the same place. Thank you, Indra ma'am. Okay. Shruti ma'am, this will be available on the YouTube. Tomorrow also we have a session. You can always go there and check. Ma'am, that option is available. We'll be discussing it tomorrow. How to check if the particular judgment was referred to a higher court or a higher bench from here. Thank you, Milan sir. Thank you for your time. So we'll be stopping this session now. Tomorrow we'll meet again. If you have any queries, you can write to us at contact@manupatra. I'll just contact@manupatra.com. Thank you.